Today we're here to talk about SAML, what it is, how it works, and why it's important. SAML is a secure XML-based communication mechanism for communicating identities between organizations. The name is actually an acronym from Security Assertion Markup Language, but the key thing about SAML is the primary use case it enables, which is Internet SSO. SAML eliminates the need to maintain multiple authentication credentials, such as passwords, in multiple locations. Why is this important? Three reasons. First of all, SAML increases security by eliminating additional credentials, which eliminates opportunities for identity theft. It also eliminates phishing opportunities by eliminating the number of times a user needs to log in over the internet using one of those username login forms. And in fact, recently a major SaaS application was subject to a successful phishing attack. SAML also increases application access by eliminating barriers to usage, so users no longer have to type in a password. They simply click on a link, they're in the application. And then finally, SAML eliminates administration time and costs by eliminating the duplicate effort to maintain those duplicate credentials, and also by eliminating all those extra help desk calls to reset those lost passwords. So how does SAML work? There are three entities involved. There's a user, there's an organization that maintains a directory of users and an authentication mechanism, which is called the identity provider, or IDP. And then there is an organization that hosts the target application or service, which is called the service provider, or SP. Now, these three entities are related. The user has an account at the IDP. So a good example here is this is an employer and this is an employee. The user wants to use a particular application. So let's say this is a sales manager and this is a software as a service CRM application. And the IDP and the SP are related because they want to federate identities. In this instance, it's a customer-supplier relationship. So the way SAML works is, first of all, a user attempts to access the application. This can be done by clicking a link in a portal or going directly out to an URL on the internet. When that happens, federated identity software running at the IDP kicks into action and it validates that user's identity and that that user is correctly authenticated. It then constructs a specially formatted message containing information about that user, which it then communicates to federated identity software running at the SP. That software then determines that the message has come from a known identity provider. It creates a session for that specific user in the target application and allows the user to get direct access to that application. This whole process of the SAML message being created and the operation of the two pieces of federated identity software is completely transparent to the user. All they see is they click on a link and they get into their application. So what are the benefits of SAML? Well, the first is, since it's a standard, it's reusable. For an identity provider who's implemented the software to implement a SAML connection with a service provider, they can use that same software to implement SAML connections with additional service providers who are also SAML enabled. Likewise, for the service provider, once they've got SAML software installed, they can use it to connect up to additional identity providers, say additional customers. The second benefit for SAML is that it eliminates the questionable security as well as the unquestioned administration and development costs for proprietary SSO mechanisms. And the third benefit of SAML is that the users love it because the users get direct access into the applications they need to get their jobs done.